Fresh off a trip to our attraction in Australia, it's time to tell the tale of the first known platypus who was, believe it or not, thought to be a hoax. Pretty much everyone knows platypuses are weird. They have tails like a beaver's, they lay eggs like a reptile, and they have bills like a duck's. Though this basic platypus knowledge is part of most elementary school animal and science lessons, the truth is platypuses are way weirder than most of us even realize. So weird, in fact, that the first Western scientist who inspected them believed them to be a hoax. Zoologist George Shaw was the first Western to ever describe the platypus, the bill and pelt of which were sent to him from Australia in 1799. Now, just like this two-headed cow and two-headed crow behind me here at Ripley's Believe It or Not Surfer's Paradise, George couldn't shake the feeling that he was being duped. These animals just couldn't be real, could they? Were they pranks of nature? Was he being fooled? He was out for a surprise. Shaw believed it was very possible a person might have taken an actual duck's bill and the pelt of an otter or a mole or some other animal and sent them to England to mess with him. In fact, he even cut the skin with scissors to try and find the stitches, which, of course, he couldn't. According to Shaw, the creature's duck-like bill and otter-like skin naturally excites the idea of some deceptive preparation by artificial means. He also drew a picture of what he believed the platypus to look like, which was surprisingly accurate for how little he actually had to go off of in terms of the specimen. Still, he continued to be unsure whether or not the animal was real. But why didn't people trust the platypus? It's important to keep in mind the time in which this was occurring. First of all, scientists didn't understand how a creature with attributes that linked it to both reptiles and mammals could even exist. In addition, people in the Western world were liable to be mistrustful of any specimen that came from an Eastern world, especially when it traveled through India, as the platypus sample did. This was partly because many hoaxes were already coming out of that same area. Be that as it may, scientists from anatomist to taxonomist tried in vain to understand the platypus for nearly 100 years before the truth was finally determined. Yes, platypuses are real, they're mammals, they have duck bills, and they lay eggs. If that wasn't weird enough, they're also nocturnal, and the males of the species have poisonous spurs in their hind legs that they use to fight other platypuses. Of course, this was a lot to wrap your head around in 1799. It took scientists a long time to determine that these creatures were real, like 100 years sometime, let alone to decide for certain that they laid eggs and did a lot of other cool stuff and strange things. But in true Western fashion, Australian Aborigines were already well aware of this phenomena that we now know as the platypus. I'm Sabrina Seek, and I'll be back next week with more cool stuff and strange things.